Hello, welcome back to my Let's Play of Jurassic Park the game. This is part 2, I think, of episode 3 of my Let's Play. I'm doing right now.
Good. If I can't open it, they can't either.
I'm trying to hunt down one of these dinosaurs, but I have a feeling something's gonna go wrong here.
There's the place to hide. Here they come.
I hope he didn't hear that.
Thousands.
Idioto! Do you know what you've done?
Hey! In case you didn't notice, it wasn't exactly a leisurely stroll over here.
You dropped it. You find it.
Hold your horses. That T-Rex is still out there.
The guard trying to be stealthy.
Okay, so we know where it is. Go get it!
Yeah, I think I'll wait until our friend there leaves to find a new chew toy.
I don't know if we have time. If the embryos go bad, they're worthless!
The embryos are worthless to me if I get eaten by a damn lizard.
If you're not man enough to get the embryos back, I'll do it myself.
Hang on. The deal is I hold on to the embryos until we reach your contact.
I know! And instead, you drop them!
Yeah, well, crap. You're gonna use logic.
Just go and hurry.
Right, looks like I'm gonna play stealthy.
Damn it, Billy, get it together. Just take it slow and don't get yourself killed. Oops.
Really takes a lot of concentration.
Oh. Hello, darling. What brings a nice girl like you to a place like this? Got it! Open the door, open the door! Woo!
Bye! That was scary.
I got it! Somebody tell Carl Lewis I got some training tips for him!
Okay, great. Nice moves out there.
Hey, thanks.
Almost makes up for dropping it in the first place.
Oh no, I need to pause it for a sec. I need to do something quickly. I forgot to set my timer, so I'm gonna do it now. While I got the chance. And there you go. Okay, resume. Why?
No!
What? Maybe I was too slow. Let's try again. It's probably because I didn't start pushing it straight away. Okay, why? Come on, get up. Okay. For being so big, I'm impressed with that guy's stealth.
What? I saw eyes.
Probably a rat or something. Keep moving.
No, I saw eyes just like that before I was beaten. I won't go through that again.
Big, shiny eyes?
You saw them too?
Not here, but yeah.
Go on. Get out of here.
Keep your voice down.
Come on, we gotta keep moving.
No way! Not until I can see where I'm going.
Okay, we can't go back outside because of our old friend Rexy, but maybe we can get the lights on. It seems like those things, whatever they are, like to stick to the shadows.
Let's turn the lights on.
We're in luck. This looks like a power panel right here.
What's the holdup?
It's nothing. It's just a different, model than I'm used to, is all.
So, you're stuck.
You know anything at all about electrical systems?
Nada.
This can't be much harder than disarming a burglar alarm.
What do you know about disarming burglar alarms?
Did I say disarming? I meant installing. I had a job doing that once.
Push to close?
Push to close. Close what? Well, that was my best guess.
Why don't you just read the instructions? They're right there, no?
I just noticed
them. This thing is just a glorified fuse box. All right, I got it now. Close your eyes. You're about to lose your... night vision.
He's made it easier for them now.
What's going on? Dad?
Over here, Jess. It's all right. The backup generator wasn't meant to last this long, that's all.
No, that's not it. We should have been fine for days.
How the hell was I supposed to know open meant turn everything off? I mean, it's counterintuitive.
You would know if you read the instructions.
Why don't you yell a little louder? I think there's a dinosaur on the other side of the island that didn't hear you. Jeez.
Whatever. There's a close, right?
There's a close, right? Yeah, I'll close that crap right up. Yeah, that's right. Who's your... Oh, come on!
I think we messed around a bit too much.
Army Bridges! Rockin' Jurassic Park's only unofficial radio station. Just a reminder before we sign off, Barklings, if you're not on the boat by 7, you're not going to be on the boat at all. I've got a little something special for all you last-minute packers out there, a personal favorite of mine, and I'll see you all on board.
Damn it, Artie.
He's not still here, is he?
No. From the sound of it, he queued up this last bit of tape and took off.
So here's a little sign to get you ready to set sail.
Am I gonna kill it? Okay. Try again. That was... Oh, this is... This bit's hard.
Where do you think you're going?
This part's really hard.
Where do you think you're going?
This bit's really hard.
Where do you think you're going?
What? Oh, come on, I did that right this time. Stop him!
Artie, this show is over.
Laura, you are my new favorite person.
You've forgiven me for fixing the lysine problem?
Don't push it.
Holy crap, Oscar. Did you just take one of those things out by hand?
Why are you here?
You're supposed to be at the crash site.
Yeah, the plan didn't factor in an angry T-Rex, so we had to change it. I didn't think to engage it in a knife fight, sorry.
We had to change the
plan. That's right. I unlocked the mystery behind the shaving cream can. Turns out, little Miss Sunshine here is smuggling dino embryos off the island.
What? I don't buy it. You don't have the skills to pull off a heist like that.
She knows her business, Oscar.
You said the same thing about that waitress in Bogota's cooking.
That wasn't her fault. That was Seminilla.
They're real. My client had someone on the inside, a man named Nedry. He didn't show, so they sent me to find the embryos. I'm the backup plan.
Well?
Squares with what I know. They're searching San Jose for this Nedry guy. Thought he was on the last boat.
They can stop the search. He's dino food.
Let me guess, you have a plan.
Yeah, well, turns out these things are worth a lot of money to the right people. I mean, a lot.
Right, sorry about that. I got interrupted there. But I'm back now. I think I'm gonna say... Yeah.
You're pretty self-righteous for a thief.
I wouldn't be a thief if you hadn't stolen this island from my people in the first place.
I didn't steal anything. The Costa Rican government rented this place to InGen.
And you did their dirty work, didn't you?
I did my job. just like I'm doing now.
Really? And how many people are you going to kill today?
Shut the hell up, or I'll start counting with you.
Whoa, whoa, no fighting. Save it for the dinos, huh?
You going along with her?
Hey, I'm not doing anything unless you're down, but come on, Oscar. Do you really think InGen gives a rat's ass about us? Look what happened to B-Team, to Decaf. Their families are gonna get a puny check, a gag order, and nothing else.
Do I gotta remind you we're working against the clock? There's no time to save these people and be her errand boys before this place turns to ground zero.
What do you mean, ground zero?
Nothing. We could do it, Oscar. We've got a call for another helicopter anyway, so one of us takes the eggheads back to the mainland and the other takes her to meet her contact.
Let me guess. That last part would be up to you.
You just tell InGen that I bought it like the rest of the guys they sent. Then you and I hook up later to split our cut.
I trust you, but I don't trust her.
Yeah.
I don't know, Billy. InGen throws a lot of work our way. Not sure I want to burn that bridge.
I understand, but we're talking about a retirement level payout here. Look, you don't have to decide now. Plenty of time before we call for another chopper.
All right, let's move out. Take it slow and quiet.
Let's not start this again. I respect your opinion, Jerry. Although, to be honest, I'm a little surprised at your lack of regard for the animals.
It's not that I don't care about them, Laura. It's just there are so many unintended consequences that come with your decision. We can't keep this a secret, Laura.
Shoot.
We need contingency plans. We'll need to monitor things outside of the park.
Where is it? I know it. Yes.
Dad! Run!
Jess, what's wrong?
What happened?
Come on!
Sometimes I press the wrong buttons.
Get away if you can! Go! I can't keep this up for long!
I'm gonna run them all back.
No!
Oh, you gotta be really quick sometimes.
Go! I can't keep this up for long!
It's ridiculous how quick you need to be.
Chief! Oh, please, please, please! Oh, thank God. Reverse!
This way! Come on, stay with me! You sure you want to take care of business? Your last friend wasn't so lucky!
That guy's a badass. Not even in the way.
What the?
Amazing. I've never seen them afraid before.
That was awesome!
No problem.
Okay, hon. Let the man breathe.
Yoder! You're alive!
We're alive? I'm surprised you guys lasted 5 minutes without me and Oscar.
Thank you.
Forget it.
Oh my God, you're bleeding! Are you okay?
No worries. Belongs to one of them.
You killed one of them? With a knife? That's so badass.
Well, hey, I outran a T-Rex.
It's nothing. Just another fight.
So, Yoder, how did you guys, like, not die when the helicopter crashed?
Well, me and Oscar got out on our own before we hit, but Nima needed a little help. Isn't that right, Oscar?
Well, I'm just glad you're all okay. Are you gonna get a tattoo of a raptor now? I totally would.
Not a bad idea.
You aren't fooling me.
What now?
You can pretend to be a hero all you want, but we both know what you really are.
You're right. We do.
Everyone, we have a problem.
What's wrong, Laura?
You've seen the flickering lights, now the steam eruptions. Something's gone wrong with the island's geothermal power plant.
That's not our problem.
When the power plant explodes, it will be.
It's that bad?
Everything I've read about the system says it's supposed to shut itself down if something goes wrong with the steam pressure. The fact that it hasn't means that the pressure will build unchecked. It'll pop like a balloon and take half the island with it.
Can we get to the power plant from here? I'm completely turned around.
Yes, I've been here before. It's down this way. We really ought to get moving.
How can we stop the power plant from exploding?
We have to do something, and quickly, but I won't know exactly what until we get there.
No time. Say goodbye to your dinosaurs, Doc. You can dig up the fossils later.
When the power plant explodes, it'll take us with it. Unless you have a spare helicopter ready to lift off.
Oh, this just keeps getting better and better.
Listen up. You're gonna show me the corridor that goes to the power plant. I'm gonna scout ahead and make sure there's no dinosaur party happening when we get there.
Can I come? I know I can help.
You're staying right here where I can keep an eye on you.
Hey, I saved you, remember? Besides, those things are afraid of him.
You wandered off, Jess.
Oscar doesn't mind, do you? Oscar?
I think he does.
When I saw the helicopter crash into the jungle, I thought you guys were goners.
We're fine. Hey, about before, the hostage thing? I'm sorry. I was only trying to protect myself. Me and the mercs, we worked it out.
Worked it out? How?
Don't worry about it. We're okay. For now.
That's great! So everyone's friends now, huh?
I wouldn't put it like that.
Then how would you... No way! Did you guys make out?
We've decided that we can all work together. Let's put it that way.
Hey, Oscar's back. What'd you find, buddy?
Hallway's clear, but the door to the plant is locked.
Don't that just figure?
Either of you got a key?
I'm afraid not.
How about a smoke?
I wish. I swore I had some on me, but... Jess? Something to share?
I'm sorry. I just wanted to borrow them. But then the dinosaur was there, and I threw them, and I think it ate them.
Jessica Marie Harding! First, you get caught stealing a t-shirt from the mall. Then you steal binoculars from the park and lie about it to my face. Now you've taken Laura's cigarettes? You let the raptors get to us because you wanted to smoke?
How was I supposed to know there were dinosaurs in here?
That's not the point. It's not just the smoking, it's stealing. It's not listening. Remember, the main reason you're on this island is because your mother thinks I might be able to straighten you out. Somehow.
Right. Not because you want to see me or anything. Look, you don't have to worry about me, Dad. I'm almost 15. I can take care of myself. I don't need you or Mom or anyone.
Oh, honey, I know it feels like that. Especially at your age, but you're not an adult. You might be a young woman,
physically, but emotional maturity takes time.
Okay? I'm sorry, Dad, but how many times have you been married? Your kids? Have you even talked to Sarah lately? This year even? Should you be lecturing anyone about emotional maturity?
Damn. Burn. Plant's gonna blow, right? We ain't got time for this after-school special crap.
That is really not fair, Jess. Even adults don't understand everything. But my point is still valid. You're a 14-year-old.
Wow. We'll sort this out in the next episode because I just ran out of time. Again, don't worry, we'll carry on from this very point next time. Thank you all very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you all later. Bye!